Audra McClain. I thought the showcase was excellent. Very pleasantly surprised. Always excited to see what local artists are bringing to the table, and I'm very impressed.
Why are you taping? Hey.
What's up?
Go ahead.
So I actually directed Hot and Loaded.
Oh.
Yeah.
And what was another film that you liked?
I definitely enjoyed Dose and the Intergalactic Dating One.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, that was very impressive.
Somebody yelled in the theater. That was weird.
Yeah,
that was interesting.
But I think I know who it is. Okay, so I love my daughter's movie because she's my daughter. It's a default, but my favorite is Intergalactic.
Intergalactic?
Perfect.
We're conducting an interview. We'll get you next. Thank you.
Hey, the whole thing was great. I think my favorite, other than my daughter's, was Get Lost. Was it Get Lost? Right?
Get Lost.
Get Lost. Yeah.
Perfect. Can you say Intergalactic?
Oh yeah, that guy Intergalactic was cool.
I love it.
It's very disruptive. Very disruptive.
Hey, so this is actually my very first film festival, and I did not know what to expect. So, surprised to say, this was better than what I expected. I'm actually going to start coming to them a whole lot more now. You know, I just didn't know this creative side of Jacksonville. It's pretty awesome.
Hell yeah. Which one was your favorite one?
My favorite one is between Dose or Intergalactic Dating. I could not decide between the two. But I guess when it's that good, when you can't decide, it just shows that there's so much creativity and potential there.
Let's do this. Let's do this. Right. So what you think?
I thought it was really, really good, man. I got a lot of talented filmmakers out here.
Okay.
It was just nice.
What'd you really think?
It was good, man.
What was trash? You can say it. Nobody's looking. Okay, ready? Okay, so this is the real thing. No audition tape. And what'd you think of the movies?
I thought it was fabulous from what I saw. I mean, I spent most of the time outside with the screaming child. But, you know, everyone came out happy, and I was happy, and I assume everybody's happy. So, huzzah.
Wait, where is the baby, by the way?
He's, I don't know. I lost him in the popcorn machine.
We did The Third Degree.
Okay. What was that about?
Basically about a group of people, which is actually a group of a girl's multiple personalities, and they're trying to be separated, there's a doctor trying to separate them from each other, basically, and they do what they have to stay together.
Oh, okay. And what's another film that y'all liked, or which one did you like?
Some Fun Tonight. It was very, very good. Very good. Everything about it was really good.
Oh yeah? What'd you like about it?
The cinematography, the shots. It was very simple, but it was very...
It's effective.
Yes.
It was good. Okay. What about you guys? What'd you think?
That was a great one. That was a great one, but I was really feeling the intergalactic space dating because of how it did get meta. And then like it was on point. And I just thought it was cool.
It was playful with like the construct of film, you know what I mean? Like the apparatus of cinema. But my favorite was Dose. That was absolutely my favorite because all of the editing and everything. I like when sequences repeat themselves with slight differences, and that happened in Dose. So I like it.
Focus.
Right, in camera or at you?
Camera. Yeah. Or me, I don't care. Just look somewhere around here.
I thought it was an incredible showcase. I was at the last one for the horror film showcase, and it was pretty impressive, and I was consistently encouraged by the film scene here in Jacksonville, and I was really impressed by all 16 films.
Which one was trash?
The ones that didn't make it. I do PR for a living. I'm not gonna say anything negative on this camera.
Which one was your favorite? Just
my,
one.
My favorite.
If you had to pick one.
I went with The Trip. I was really the taking the step back from watching it. The scene that I can picture is just the bananas to the head. Like that's the picture that's like of the whole thing that's stuck in my head. And it's staying there. So I gotta go with The Trip. But I thought that Mean Green was really funny. I think I got it once it got into it. I thought it was like hysterical. And then the first one where it was like one shot, it was kind of cool that they did that, something sort of new. And then, I mean, I was laughing hysterically with Intergalactic Dating. I was just like, I mean, the guerrilla marketing in the middle, let me just tell you, that Jay guy, I mean.
It's kind of rude though, just some guy interrupting while we're watching
a movie. I don't think it was rude at all.
That didn't make no sense to me.
I thought it had like some showmanship. You know what I mean? It wasn't just like on screen. It was like you were immersed in the experience of being part of it. I felt like I was on the dating show myself.
I disagree, but we'll leave it at that.
You wouldn't want to date me?
You're not an alien.
Well now, hello everyone. This is Kendall, and I really enjoyed the short film showcase. There was some amazing talent. There was Six. There was a troll, which I starred in as well. And I mean, it was great. I mean, I pretty much tried to figure out, you know, what short film that we were going to represent. And my amazing actor John, he was there, and I have to give a shout out to my director Jay, amazing talent Deb Ness, and her sister, amazing talent. And I really enjoyed the show, and I look forward to seeing everybody else at the next short film festival. So good time. All in all, you know, lots of laughs, lots of smiles, and There were actual clowns. There were actual clowns.
So which one was the favorite? The favorite film?
I like the Trolls one. And I liked Once.
Which one?
Once.
Oh, yeah.
With the girl having those fantasies?
They were getting freaky on the palette.
The wooden palette.
You better watch out.
No, she needs to watch out. Hey, bring this camera.
Yeah, let me bring it back right here. Okay.
They're not ready for this.
Well, which one was your favorite out of all of them? What'd you think?
Those.
You like those?
Yeah, I think technically it was definitely the best.
Had like a Fight Club feel to it, like towards the end.
Yeah. I feel like it had the most clear direction as well.
Yeah.
So I guess those. By my boy Trey Ballmer.
Hell yeah.
Sorry, I forgot your name wrong.
This is where the corruption begins.
That's why democracy doesn't fucking work. People like him.
Wave it. Everybody wave.
A bunch of white men watching a white man suffocate.
It's hot.
Yeah.
No, little. You haven't seen it yet?
No, I just got here.
So 11 o'clock? I'll get you ready. 9 o'clock. Okay.
So, my name is William Bishop, and.
My name is Gabby Bautista. We directed Hot and Loaded. And
starring Joe Nowlin and Taylor Mejia.
Uh huh.
And, the film that I thought was really interesting was I really loved the lighting and the visual design of Dose. That film was pretty incredible.
That was pretty cool, right? It had that Fight Club feel at the end.
Oh, definitely.
Like, I didn't expect it.
The red lighting matched with like the blue, like really like subtle undertones. It was very well done.
What Richard Kodai has done with this is amazing. The Jacksonville film community is going nuts. I was in the film Kelly. Five Bodies, Two Takes is a wonderful film.
That was good. I liked that one.
I think Get Lost is a lot of fun. You know, murder for no reason just because some girl won't go on a date with you. I think we can all relate to that.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I had a great time. There were some great shows.
Yeah, really great.
Really fun.
And Richard's between films... repertoire is getting better too, so.
Oh, sure.
Yeah. I still wanted to see him in a film with Jay Beard, but.
Oh, yeah, no. Oh, well.
Disappointed we shall be.
We'll make that happen.
Yeah, fuck it.
Hi, I'm Brooke Brando. My film was A Child's Play. There's a bunch of awesome movies at the showcase tonight. Really good. Really great. Lots of them. I don't know, there's lots of favorites. I don't want to pick out one. I just think they're all very creative. really good cinematography and editing and directing, and very creative writing.
Yeah. Alright, what are
not
we doing?
Me,
why'd you fuck up my first film? How come that one didn't play?
Like, this guy, that?
Hey!
We are Pig Tree Productions. Our submission to the showcase this year was Want, starring Elena... Nick, you say her last name because it is so difficult for
it's
me.
It's Shapochnik.
Shapochnik.
And I probably still messed that up.
Yeah, great job. But he was, yeah, he was in it that's here right now. Myself, Sam Forrester, and Daniel Endhart directed it. Overall, about the entire showcase, though, it was fantastic. I was pleasant. Yeah, it was really good. My personal favorite had to have been Dose, last one of the show, but there were a lot of really good ones. There's a good top five, at least, that I'm constructing in my head right now that were really good.
Everybody's
one thing, that I really loved and I didn't know that we could do was with intergalactic dating, where they had the interactive part. I actually, now that I know we're allowed to
but it was
kind of,
it was kind of disruptive, though, yeah. Like just yelling in the middle of the theater. I don't know about that.
It was very, very avant-garde.
Avant-garde?
There was a lot of high production value tonight, which I appreciated.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I was going to say myself that probably intergalactic dating made me feel the best.
Yeah. So that'd be my favorite as far as... Not even like audience participation, but like it actually...
It was unexpected. It,
exactly.
It took us out a little bit. Yeah. It was good. It was a way to use the medium in a very...
Yeah, it was just a very clever idea. It was great.
Dose was probably my favorite, but intergalactic dating was great. Very original concept. And I was just really excited to see so much of a turnout for independent film here in Jacksonville.
Yeah.
That's really, really exciting for us.
I mean, it's...
Film lovers and...
It really is so nice, though, to see that like there were two showings and both of them sold out.
Yeah.
It's awesome, especially for us just like really getting into it. This is like our first foray into it.
Yeah, it's exciting, like, I don't know, just grassroots creators. It's really, really cool.
Yeah.
I hope to see more stuff like this in Jacksonville.
A lot of great talent.
Gives us a lot of confidence.
Yep.
Hell yeah.
I'm very excited for what we can do now.
Filming. Say that again. Take two. All right.
Hello, I'm Nadia Ramatar, and this is Pat Murphy.
Patrick Murphy.
Ryan McNair.
So what did you guys think of the film?
We thought the films were wonderful. We were so proud of people who obviously put a lot of time and effort into it. And we saw 16 films, right? 16, and a tremendous amount of talent and heart and caring and a lot of originality. And we really want to say congratulations for getting a film done, because it's supposed to be on a screen with an audience with a bunch of strangers.
Right, a few were dogs, though. But most of them were
hey, does this make
very,
you the,
very good.
Does this make you the Simon Cowell of this? Like, I'm
yes,
all
I
pleasant
have to be,
and so. Upbeat.
Okay.
And you're yeah. Like...
yeah, there were a few dogs.
Yeah.
But there were some that were amazing. A few great.
Work on lighting. Work on audio. And story. Right?
Story, the script, yeah, they need to work.
So basically everything.
Well, no.
Just revamp the whole thing.
So, no, some things are more important than others.
Yeah.
But story for most of us is number one. And then don't let your acting show. Subtle acting.
Oh, that's interesting.
Is a really important thing. The minute we can see you acting, the director needs to say cut and just have them do it again for you.
That's interesting advice.
Yes.
Okay.
Right, and I was actually surprised the acting was good on most of them. We enjoyed that.
That's good. People are getting better. Every year
they
it gets better.
Better.
Yeah.
And the lighting's getting better. The audio's getting better.
We'll match Hollywood one day.
That's right.
I hope so.
Kind of. Anything else?
Characters were wonderful, and it was really enjoyable. I loved the interaction in the galaxy, intergalactic dating. That was great with the audience participation. It was enjoyable.
Just say that. Just say that. Interview? No?
Oh, I'm good. Thank you. It was awesome.
They should have to advertise
that
shit.
I hate you.
Hi, this is John from This Is The Contest, and my film that I like is The Dose. Really creative. That's it.
Hi, Kenny here. I was in Kelly. Interesting. And I died. It was awesome. But I say that intergalactic dating with Jay Bear showing up in the middle of the film, looked fantastic.
What's up? I'm Justin Mann. I directed Kelly. Another film that I liked a lot was Get Lost.
All right.
right. I thought all of them were pretty good. Some of them were a little bit violent, but you know, I got to vote for my son's movie, Intergalactic Dating, or is that right? Yeah, because you know, it was the best one.
All right, here we go. Ready? Let's do this.
Is this a good background? Is this a good...
Yo, what you want?
I want to be where you were teleported.
My name is Adam Madrid. The movie I did was Intergalactic Dating. Awesome, awesome experience. Great cast and crew. The other film that I enjoyed very much was actually Dose, and actually Child's Play worked out really great. So, yeah, it was a fun time.
I was in Kelly and Kill Your Demon. And then I went out and decided to get drunk, so I didn't see any of the other movies. But Javier was my favorite one, even though half his little sketch thing got fucked up, apparently. But Javier, for sure, had the best one.
A word, Cynthia Roy. So what'd you thought of the showcase?
I don't think they should have done it. They shouldn't have done it. It was a waste of time. They shouldn't have done it. No,
seriously.
Sucked.
The old trash?
It was fun. The first one sucked, the second one sucked, the third one sucked. Was there a fifth one?
I think
there was. Did I miss four?
No, I think we're on five.
There was a four and a five. They all sucked. No, it was great. I loved it. It was a great time. Everyone was here. It was fun to see.
Which one was your favorite one?
I don't know. Probably, Kelly.
Oh, Kelly was pretty cool.
Yeah. It was cool. Awesome. But yeah, they all sucked. Richard has underdone himself this time.
Yep.
He has been underdone. Underdid by himself, and it's his own fault, so he's gonna have to live with that.
He screwed one of my movies up.
Did he?
In the first showing,
I thought
it didn't show up.
He's a douchebag.
He's a douchebag. I'm done with him.
I don't blame you. Let's start our own showcase.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
We'll call it the Case Show.
Yes.
Just so there's no,
yeah. You know. We call it. Instead
doesn't
of
make
a
sense.
J, we'll do like a KH.
That's it.
It'll work. We'll start our own fucker.
All right. Yeah. I think we're done now.
We're done.
Right. I'm never in films. I don't do films. I'm not a filmmaker.
We don't have any change.
I thought he was.
She's fixing her hair. I'm fixing my hair.
Yep. Everybody get hair fixed. Yep. Paper in mouth. And let's do this.
So Get Lost was a story about what happens to women when they reject men.
Ooh.
We'll kill you. Fucking kill you. No, I think that was a beautiful, beautiful story about you know, man loves woman, woman rejects man, man kills woman. Unlike my movie, Kelly, which was man loves woman who is a sister, man kills a lot of people because sister is a drug addict.
And then you'll blow your head off.
Yeah, I think it has a lot to do with. I mean, it goes back and forth.
Very PG rated.
Yeah, it really is transferable.
Right.
Yeah. You know, because women are drug addicts. I think it's what the lessons we learned tonight.
Women don't trust anybody.
No.
Nobody.
Especially women.
Perfect.
Can you walk me home?
That was the perfect ending.
My name is Philippe Bougemont. You might know me as 22. I kill people sometimes. Tonight I came out to the awards, and we're not awards yet. I came out to the showcase. But the film I liked the most was Dose by my man Trey Ballmer. Josue was in it, and his acting was great. And overall, the experience was good tonight. The film definitely stepped it up a notch this time. And I like where direction is going with the showcase. I think it's growing, it's improving, and I hope it keeps doing that. So. Enjoy. If you didn't see it, go check it out online when they put it up.
Perfect. And we just got Goose Mouth.
Yes.
All right, so the one favorite film I had, aside from one other favorite film that I saw, it would either have to be a hung jury between Intergalactic Dating, Get Lost, or Dose. All three were pretty amazing films. I mean, I especially love the interactive element where one of the guys in the audience answered the call and kind of stormed out the theater.
It's kind of disruptive, wasn't it? Just weird people doing that.
I mean, I'll admit it kind of caught me off guard at first, but
I just love the interactive experience. Really pointing at the future of cinema.
I was part of Kelly. I did the DP and Kelly with Justin Mann, his man short. And the overall tone of the whole entire thing was awesome. Everybody had seemed like they had a great time. It was a great turnout, great filmmakers. I think my favorite movie, besides being Kelly, two shots in the whole movie, you know, killer, was probably the Russian Roulette one, where the guy was breathing all that killer cold air out of his nose and mouth the whole time. You know, gave a lot of great motion to still camera action, you know. Everybody had a great time.
It is the Sharon Cobb. Sharon Cobb.
There you go.
What do you think about the showcase?
I think it's fantastic because we get to see all the films and talent from our local filmmakers and also our great actors, right?
Yeah, right.
Yeah, yeah, great actors. So, and writers are pretty good too.
Yeah, maybe you. You know?
Thank you.
That's a great turnout tonight. I did love all the movies, actually. You know, everything was pretty good tonight. Let me see. Those was rocking. And also, what was the name of that other one? Had Some Fun? Or
which one?
Having Some Fun.
Oh, with the guy?
Oh, yeah. And the Tall Paul?
Yeah, Having Fun.
Yeah, Having Fun. Yeah. That was great, too. And I just wanted to say, great job, guys. You know, local filmmakers, I do support you all. I just wish that it was a short film showcase again, so I had two films that to be screened. Well, I'll wait for my next.
So what'd you think? What was the favorite film, or overall, maybe that they suck? What was the mood?
No.
What was the mood?
Overall, really good. Yeah, okay. Really good.
Which one?
Really good. Well done films. More than normal, because usually you get like a few good, some
just
average,
trash,
and then it was like less trash. So.
Less trash. Which one was the favorite one, though? The favorite, like, what? Which one unanimously you think people are gonna lean towards? What do you think?
Probably Dose.
Dose?
I mean, so, it is professionally done.
Yeah.
I don't know. His shirt matched the.
The theme.
The commercial.
Yeah.
I know. I was totally gonna order the.
Yeah. I want to order the CDs too.
Okay. Okay, we're good. All right, so go ahead. What'd you think?
Overall, I did like the short films going on in there. There were a lot of good ones and a lot of surprises. Like a lot of friends I didn't know that were actually in certain films.
Which one was your favorite?
I gotta say my favorite would have to be Dose.
Cause you're a heroin addict? So what'd you think about the showcase? It's a success?
It's fucking awesome, man. I mean, it's getting better every time, you know? That's it. J-Beer was in it, jumping up and down. Always good stuff. Are we done? I got these votes to count.
This guy's rocking.
Oh, you're actually gonna... Oh, it's not corrupt? You're actually gonna count them?
Yeah, I'm... Yeah,
oh, you, yeah, you
that's...
Oh,
yeah.
It's not a lie.